it's helpful in your mind to split it in three parts. Yeah? So you have your background, which forms more or less the sky, which is the furthest away thing from you. And there's the mid-ground, so that in this case it's a bunch of trees that are kind of getting lost in the distance with the cypresses. And then slowly coming up to the cypresses in the front, and all of this grass up here is my foreground. So if you split your space in these three parts, it's a little bit easier to comprehend what you...
There's really, when you're outside, there's really no rules in terms of you shouldn't add this to, you shouldn't add white to your shadows, because that's not true on a gray day.
That one, it has a bit of, it's kind of a gray, so it's black. Okay. With ochre, so it makes it a little bit of green, and then you add white to it. And a little bit of yellow ochre, just so that it's a little bit more, almost like a neutral gray. The yellow and the black is to tone it down. Get your light sky set up, it's easier to put in a branch on top of it, you know, rather than painting sky, and you're painting something that has a lot more air in it. So it's helpful to kind of think along those lines.